All right, so call our first budget workshop to order, and I think our first order of business is to view a video.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman. This is a video provided to us by the North Carolina County Commissioners Association.
Hello, I'm David Thompson, your executive director of your North Carolina Association of County Commissioners. One of our key jobs is to keep you updated on major events at the General Assembly. This year's session has been very challenging thus far. There's been a significant amount of change in the legislature in recent years. For example, there are 56 members serving in their first term and another 44 just beginning their second term serving in the General Assembly. That means that out of 170 legislators, 100 have less than 3 years of experience. We need you to continue to help educate the new members of the General Assembly about the unique and important partnership that exists between counties and the state of North Carolina.
County 101 is a program we started this year with help from the UNC School of Government and the staff of the General Assembly. The program offered an orientation to new legislators about how county and state governments work together to provide services to our citizens. Most of the new members had never served in county government before they were elected to the legislature. We need you to remind them to consider the county perspective when debating legislation.
So many new legislators in Raleigh means lots of new ideas in Raleigh. Of the more than 1,700 bills introduced so far, about 20% directly impact county governments. Not only are we working to achieve the 60 legislative goals the membership adopted, we are responding to those bills that either do something good or bad to counties. You can access a complete list of bills we are following by clicking on the Advocacy tab on our website. Several things are really taking a lot of our attention at the moment.
One of our county's biggest priorities is lottery funding for school construction. The legislature has reduced the county share of lottery proceeds for each of the last 3 years and has taken all of the ADM funds for counties for the past four. Altogether, counties have lost nearly $500 million of funds for school construction needs. We need you to tell your legislators how this has impacted your county and to stress the importance of receiving the full share of lottery proceeds.
One legislative goal where we have seen progress is to help counties better manage costs for providing medical care for inmates in county jails. Proposed legislation will give counties the same ability as the state to cap the rates hospitals can charge for inmate medical expenses. We need you to contact your senators and make sure they know county support Senate Bill 321.
Many bills have been filed to erode county authority or to reduce the county property tax base. We urge you to look at Senate Bill 612, which prohibits a county from adopting any environmental ordinance that is stronger than an existing state or federal law. Bills have been filed to expand the homestead exemption and to make it easier for farms to qualify for present use value. Both of these ideas and others would negatively impact the county property tax base.
One of our overriding goals is to increase county authority because we believe that locally elected county commissioners know what is best for their communities. Senate Bill 287 allows some counties the option to provide public notices on their websites in lieu of purchasing ads in local newspapers.
There you go.
This bill passed the Senate on April 23rd. While it only impacts 10 counties, we need you to support this measure as a first step towards achieving this legislative goal on a statewide basis.
Good.
Heading into this session, tax reform was considered a major issue. Several bills have been introduced to suggest some level of tax reform, but no comprehensive reform package has seen legislative action. We have been assured by Senate leadership that county property tax will not be a part of the tax reform discussion. That said, we are keeping a close eye on local sales taxes and other locally levied taxes, and we need you to remind your legislators that county revenues must be protected in tax reform.
As you can see, there's a lot going on in Raleigh that could negatively or positively impact the services that you provide to your citizens. We need your help. Our philosophy is simple and remains unchanged. The best advocates for county government are locally elected county commissioners speaking to locally elected state representatives. That is why we hope to see you in Raleigh on May 22nd for our County Assembly Day.
County Assembly Day is a unique opportunity for you to come to Raleigh and be directly involved in our state's public policy process. The association staff will be here to help you every step of the way. You'll also have the opportunity to hear from leaders themselves, talk directly to you about the important issues of the day. Your association has been serving counties for over 100 years. It's a proud tradition of public service, and we thank you for all that you do to support your association and all 100 counties.
Got one thing to say. I appreciate this. That was some items in this. It started off our meeting we had, our district meeting, then it went further, and that's kind of good because there's some things in there that were germane to what we do. And to that effect, I would like to support and present a resolution at the next general meeting that we have, June 3rd, in support of the Senate bill, local bill, for allowing counties to put electronic legal notices on their website.
I've called in the past few weeks trying to get Beaufort County added to that bill. Initially, it started out it was going to apply as an option for all counties, yeah. But my understanding now they've changed it so that there's only a handful of counties.
Yeah. I think we're going to have to wait to the short session.
And we've asked that Beaufort be added to the to that bill, but we don't know yet. But
it's already approved.
But yeah, but it's for the short for those few counties. But we can
for those counties.
If we can't get it this year, we got to be pushing for the short session next year. Like we've just found out, we can save $25,000 just with those tax notices. And when we put your name up, it stays up all year. Maybe
another thing they mentioned in the video, the bill about the county jail medical costs, that mm-hmm. has also passed, and that applies for every county. So that will be a good thing for us as well.
Good, very good. You got that, JoJo? Thank you.
Okay.